I get asked the question a lot, what book should I read to become an electrician? First of all, I say to everybody, you should read the books recommended by your college to suit the course that you're currently sitting. And to read those books is not just to buy those books. So it's like subscribing to a YouTube channel. I've subscribed to a YouTube channel. It's like buying a book and never reading it. If you're asked to buy books at college, please make sure you read them. If you're not going to read them, don't purchase them and save the money. However, books that I would recommend along with your course are a couple I've got on the table, plus one that I haven't been able to show before, which I have got, which I'll show you later on in the video. First of all, let's look at the books that you're likely to be required to buy throughout a four-year study program as an apprentice or a three-year study program as a full-time learner. The first book that you're likely to require is the on-site guide. And remember, as you watch this video, it will change over time. We're currently on BS 7671's 18th edition Amendment 2, which is stated down here. And that's denoted by the brown cover on three of the books I've got. However, at the time you're watching this video, this may have changed to Amendment 3, and then the 19th edition, and so on. So please make sure you buy the latest edition. To work out whether it is the latest one, you'd ask your college. And also, if it's too good to be true on price, it's likely to be an older version of the book. On-site guide is a book that I recommend to my learners. They have to buy when they're on the course, but you should read this book. This is a book that can be read. One of the books on the table here, I don't recommend you do read it and you only use it for reference, but this book here, the on-site guide, is a book that you should read. And it's fantastic as you go through when you're thinking about things like test and inspection, which is this section here, okay? And we've got things like bathrooms and other things that are very, makes you put it into context. If you look at the section in here on bathrooms, it brings it into context when you're looking at your own bathroom. So that's the on-site guide. As you move through your course and you go for your test and inspection elements of your course, so this is likely to be at level 3 or second and third year of an apprenticeship. The apprenticeship is always only at level 3. We've got the guidance notes 3 here. It might be you're expected by other guidance notes. There's not just only guidance notes 3, there are other ones. But this one is about inspection and testing. And you notice the version also has a brown strap on it to denote that it's for Amendment 2 of BS 7671's 18th edition. And then we have the 18th edition. Now, I never recommend anyone rushes out and buys this book before they start a course, because the likelihood is you will not need this straight away. And it could be that this book changes before you actually need it on your apprenticeship. So if you start year one of your apprenticeship, you might not need this book until years 2, 3, and 4. And it might be that the book has changed. And considering this is a very expensive book to buy yourself, I would never buy it until I'm asked to buy it by the course. And this is the book that I suggest to learners that they don't necessarily read it. It's used for reference only. You can see already no pictures. We're already panicking as learners. I can't see a picture anywhere as you go through this book. And this would be the only book that I'm going to show you today that I say you use for reference and work alongside your course. But you only buy it when you're required to buy it. And it might be by the time you buy it, it might be Amendment 3 or the 19th edition. And the colour will change accordingly. Now, books to help you along your course. These are my two favourite ones. And they're endorsed by the City and Guilds and the IET. So this is book one. There is two books in the series. And this one is really for when you're starting out at level 2 and level 3 on your course. So it might be that you've joined a level 2 course as a full-time learner, or you've just started out your apprenticeship, which is at level 3 in year 1. This is the book that I recommend. And it states down here some of the courses that it certainly matches to. It also matches to courses from the EAL. So this is for really City and Guilds courses. But if you're doing an EAL course, this book is also fantastic for that. And it's nice and logical. So as we look inside here at the contents, we go health and safety, makes logical sense. You're likely to do it at every course at the very start of the course. Then you've got your electrical science in section 2. 3 and 4 are what I would usually call installation theory. So about wiring systems and wiring methods. And then section 5 here is communicating with others. So that's a very logical process to work your way through. And I 100% you recommend that you read this book. So as you start a course off, you're going to be doing health and safety. And you clearly can see there some of the signs you're expected to understand what they mean based on colour and shape in those early weeks of a study programme. If we jump forward now and we look at another section, let's just randomly find something and see what we can come up with maybe in the science and principles section. So what section are we in here? We're in the blue section. That should be science and principles. Yep, so here we go. As we come through this section, there's some calculations. There's things on area, a bit of trigonometry for us as I flick through. Let's find something that may be our. So we've got classes of levers. Okay, there's three classes of levers. And you can work your way looking at mechanical advantage by looking at levers. As you can see here, we've got class two levers and class three levers. And it's where we put the fulcrum, in this case, which is the triangle, in position to the actual load itself, which makes it one of the classes of levers. If we throw ourselves forward to another section, this is more the installation theory stuff. So here we have a list of tools that we'd be using in different applications. So whether we'd be threading conduit, marking out trunking, or working with mineral insulated cables, these tools are denoted for which type of application that we need to use them for. And then as we come to the very back of them, we can actually see the principles of these tools. So here we have some making off of some fiber optic cables here. So that's good. And again, fiber optic cables are mentioned, but not necessarily done as part of the course currently. So you'd be expected to know things like fiber optic cables transmit light, and the light is transmitting information, data information, by having a light either on or off. And that uses a binary code. So ones and zeros, light is on or light is off. But you'd get a little bit of an understanding of how to make off fiber optic cables from that section there. So that's book number one. And I recommend you look at that one. Notice also it's in its second edition. So when I did this video a few years ago, this was obviously on the first one. So we're on the second edition of this book here. So again, when you go to buy these books, make sure you look for the latest edition of the books. So we're on the second edition here. So it's revised and updated. It's normally updated at the same time we change between amendments or regulations. Say we've gone to the 19th edition or amendment 3. That's when this book gets updated. But it also updates to add in other courses. And you notice now, and it's going to be very much out there in the public domain, the T-levels course. So T-levels have been added to this. So this also covers stuff that people are working at T-levels. T-levels is a 2-year level 3 course, and it's a full-time course with a huge amount of work experience. So that's a new course coming out as well. This is the book that I would suggest if you're an apprentice. This would be book that you'd buy in years 2, 3, and 4. So you'd be using it then, where book one would be your first year. And it's similar to the one before when we look at the actual layout of the book. Obviously in our contents, we've got environmental technologies and a more in-depth science and principles section here. So it takes it a little bit further. And then we start looking at the wiring regulations and things like that. So again, if we jumped into section 2, electrical science, okay, as we come in here, obviously we're going to get a little bit more detailed as we look at machinery. So you start looking at motors and machines. Great pictures, lovely text in order to work through. And there's a knowledge check in each section so you can keep up to date with your own learning. And it's a brilliant way of either keeping up with your study program by using these two books or using it as a pre-teach for yourself. So in other words, you're going into a lesson on science and principles, you're reading the section in whichever year you're in, and therefore you've got understanding of some of those complicated words, maybe inductive and capacitive reactants, words you've never heard before. But if you've used the books correctly, you'll also understand these terms as you start those lessons. That's a great way of doing a pre-teach. The book I've never managed to show you before is this one here, which is a student's guide that the IET produce. It looks like the on-site guide from its physical structure. Okay, and we know that it's the up-to-date one for me at the moment because it's denoted by Amendment 2 of BS 7671 with this brown strap in here. This continually changes. So the book tends to say black, but the strap on here will change as we go for Amendment 3 and then on to the 19th edition. And what I like about this is it's a very easy book to follow through. There's also knowledge checks in this between each section. But it adds lots of colour pictures which students find really easy. So if you weren't using these books, you could use this as an alternative or as an additionality. I do like this book. So if we do health and safety, nobody really likes health and safety, but there's covered in section 2. And as we come through, there'll be some stuff in here that we're really familiar with when we think about GS38, our test leads and test probes. So that's something that obviously is taught at the start of the course under health and safety, but pictorially here goes through again, maybe the maximum tip exposure being 4 mil, something that you'll talk about under GS38. Flow charts to do with safety, but this is what I like as well. Simply identifying hand tools. So when you turn up at a college, you might not be aware of all the tools. I'd like to think we know what a hammer looks like, but do we know what pliers and side cutters are and what the difference are as we go through those sections there? There's some fantastic stuff in here that links back to BS 7671 in all sections. So here, We've got the heights of switches in dwellings, so the maximum heights of light switches and socket outlets, etc., within dwellings. Again, nice pictorial help for you for the explanation. And again, when we come here to switching, when we start looking at one, two way switches and intermediate switches, we actually start looking at them and they show you by making and breaking the arms or the common to L1 connection, whether it be open or closed in those positions. And then we can add in the conductors when we can work out that the blue with brown is, say, a switching line, it goes through the switch, the permanent line comes through the common. It actually starts explaining to you how basic switching systems work and builds it up as you go through to two-way and then two-way and intermediate. And this is not available in the on-site guide, even though this book looks like the on-site guide, this sort of stuff is not in there. When I go back to section 11 at the back, here, this is common calculations and links nicely to your electrical science and principles. So it feels like it's a book more about installing wiring systems and the regulations. But in section 11, it gives you some help on your science. So here we've got the formula for Ohm's law, one of the formulas for power here, and it shows you how to use the triangle in order to work out whether you're multiplying or dividing to find one of your actual elements. So if you're trying to find current, you cover over current, it's voltage divided by resistance, and that's why the division sign's there. If we were trying to find power, P for power, it would be current multiplied by voltage. And it shows you how to use that triangle in this book here. So this is one that if you're in a good position to be able to afford enough books, this would be on one of my lists. It might be that you celebrate Christmas, and therefore in December you might want to put it on your list of books to have. I would first of all say to you, buy the books required from your college. Once you've bought those books, and make sure you read them. The only exception probably is the wiring regulations, that use it as a reference book, but you can read it. I just don't want to put people off. On-site guide is a book you should read. These two books here should be considered to be purchased alongside your course if they're not recommended by your college. And as a little bonus, I recommend this one here from the IET, the Student's Guide. We mentioned Ohm's Law in this video, so if you want to check out a video where I use that Ohm's Law calculation, check out the video on screen now.